السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. Believe in Allah سبحانه وتعالى is the cornerstone of Islamic faith. All of the other Islamic beliefs revolve around belief in Allah سبحانه وتعالى. It is a must that a Muslim's beliefs about Allah سبحانه وتعالى is correct. If a person's beliefs about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not correct, then his whole faith may be invalid. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked, أَيُّ الْعَمَلِ أَفْضَلِ What is the best deed? And he said, إِيمَانٌ بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ To believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger. In another narration, he said, إِيمَانٌ بِاللَّهِ وَجِهَادٌ فِي سَبِيلِ To believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to strive in his cause. Believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala starts with to believe in his existence. Even if his existence is clear and is not in need to any proof, scholars have mentioned proofs for that. First one is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, that when harm afflicts people, they call on him alone, turning to him sincerely. Everything they worship besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala disappears from their hearts and minds. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in many ayat, this is one of them, وَإِذَا مَسَّكُمُ الضُّرُّ فِي الْبَحْرِ ضَلَّ مَنْ تَدْعُونَ إِلَّا إِيَّاهِ فَلَمَّا نَجَّاكُمْ إِلَى الْبَرِّ أَعْرَضْتُمْ وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانُ كَفُورًا And when harm afflicts you upon the sea, those that you call upon beside him are lost and will leave you except him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. But when he brings you back safe to land, you turn away from him. And man is ever ungrateful. When Ikrimah ibn Abi Jahl radiallahu anhu, before accepting Islam, ran away from the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam after the conquest of Mecca, he set out across the sea to go to Ethiopia. But a stormy wind started. The people said to one another, no one can save you except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Ikrimah said to himself, Wallahi, لأن كان لا ينفع في البحر غيره فإنه لا ينفع في البر غيره By Allah, if no one can benefit on the sea except Allah, then no doubt no one can benefit on land except him. And he said, اللهم لك علي عهد لئن أخرجتني منه لأذهبن فأضعن يدي في يدي محمد فلأجدنه رؤوفا رحيما Oh Allah, I promise you that if you bring me safely out of this, I will go and put my hand in the hand of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and surely I will find him full of kindness and mercy. They came out of it safely. Then Ikrimah radiallahu anhu went to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and accepted Islam, and he became a good Muslim. Another story is when a group of people from Quraysh came to Husayn radiallahu anhu before accepting Islam as well, for he was very wise and respected person. And complained to him that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam always speaks ill of our gods. So please go to him and ask him to stop. Husayn, along with these people, went to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He made his people sit there, and he himself went inside. When the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam saw him, he said, "Awsi'u lil-shaykh, give wide place to the respected elder to sit." So Husayn said, I have been told you speak ill of our gods. Is this true? So the Prophet Muhammad asked him, Ya Husayn, kam ilahan ta'bud? Husayn, how many gods do you worship? So Husayn said, Sab'ata, sittatan fil ard wa wahidan fil sama. So Husayn said, I worship seven gods, six on the earth and one in the heaven. So the Prophet Muhammad asked him few questions. The first one, he said, فَأَيُّهُمْ تُعِدُّ لِرَغْبَتِكَ وَرَهْبَتِكَ Which God among them do you go to during your hope and fear? So Husayn said, الَّذِي فِي السَّمَاءِ The one who is in the sky. The Prophet asked him, فَإِذَا أَصَابَكَ الضَّيْقِ فَمَنْ تَدْعُو Which God do you ask when you are afflicted with harm? So Husayn said, الَّذِي فِي السَّمَاءِ The one who is in the heaven or the sky. So the Prophet asked him again, فَإِذَا أَصَابَكَ الضِّيقُ فَمَنْ تَدْعُو Which God do you ask when you are afflicted with distress? Hussein said, الذي في السماء, the one who is in the heaven. The Prophet asked him, فَإِذَا أَصَابَكَ الضُّرْ فَمَنْ تَدْعُو? Which God do you ask when you are afflicted with harm? Hussein said, الذي في السماء, the one who is in the sky. The Prophet asked him, فَإِذَا مُنِعَ الْمَطَرِ فَمَنْ تَدْعُو? Which God do you ask when you are deprived from rain? Hussein said, الذي في السماء, the one who is in the heaven. The Prophet asked him, فَإِذَا هَلَكَ الْمَالِ فَمَنْ تَدْعُو? Which God do you ask when your wealth gets destroyed? So Hussein said, الذي في السماء, the one who is in the sky. So the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ asked him, أَيَمْنَعُونَ? Do they prevent him from answering you, these six gods that you worship on earth? Do they prevent him from answering you? Hussein said, no. So the Prophet Muhammad asked him, أَيَسْتَجِيبُ لَكَ وَحْدَ أَمْ يَسْتَجِيبُونَ مَعَ? Does he answer you alone or they answer you with him? He said, he alone answers my dua. So the Prophet Muhammad said, يَسْتَجِيبُ لَكَ وَحْدَ وَتُشْرِكُ مَعَهُ غَيْرَ? He alone answers you and you worship others with him. يا حسين أما لو أسلمت علمتك كلمتين تنفعان. يا حسين, حسين, if you would but accept Islam, I would teach you two phrases or statements that would benefit you. So Hussein accepted Islam and said, O Messenger of Allah, teach me the two phrases or statement you promised me. So the Prophet Muhammad taught him, قل اللهم ألهمني رشدي وقني شر نفسي. Say, O Allah, inspire me with my guidance and protect me from the evil of my soul. From these stories, you can see that people believe that no one can benefit anyone or remove any hardship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. As he subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِن يَمْسَسْكَ اللَّهُ بِضُرٍ فَلَا كَاشِفَ لَهُ إِلَّا هُوَ وَإِن يَمْسَسْكَ بِخَيْرٍ فَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala touches you with affliction, there is no one to take it off but He. And if He touches you with good, then He has power over all things. Now, put your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and never doubt in Him afterward. Just do your best and trust Him and rely on Him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one who can change your situation from hardship to ease. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is always here for you. He never leaves. If you ever need someone to talk to, remember He is always there for you and He has your back. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to remove all the hardship and give us the good of this life and the good of the hereafter. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية في الدين والدنيا والآخرة. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم, وتب علينا يا مولانا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. وصل اللهم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم, والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله.